Because to be fair, there are, like, you know, limited people qualified for this one, right? So that is something that could actually happen. Can I keep this hand? I think so. I think we have enough good draws that this is keepable. I'm not quite sure. The fourth land is like almost always a mulligan though, so maybe this is a ship. But Mayhem Dev is like our best card in most matchups, so having that already is real nice. And Oven works very well with Reaper. And there's an oven. Alright, so we play against. So this is Gruul, I assume? What does that mean for me? I think that means I lead on Oven, so that they can't bone crush a giant to kill my Cold and Familiar in response to Oven next turn. But yeah, that was just a perfect draw. Exactly what I was looking for. And now this hand is great. But it was inspired by the standard Gruul player? Yeah, maybe. Apparently someone made day two with just standard Gruul. It was quite a sight to behold. Alright, so there's a Bone Crusher in hand. Maybe? Is it a braid? It's not a braid. Yeah, I should start earlier day two. It's just I slept away most of my day yesterday, so today I just did not know what to play and I spent some time trying to figure it out. And what I did figure out was that I did not want to play green in my red-black deck, so I didn't want company. So thanks to Tristan for helping me figure that out. I still wasn't sure if I wanted to play red-black or teamer engine and which version of red-black, or like, which build of it, and which build of teamer in that case, so I still had like some things to figure out. I think I like what I ended up at, but I'm not quite sure. The teamer decks have had a really good win rate in the SCG so far, so that makes me a little curious if I just chose wrong. Oh, this is very loud, isn't it? And yeah, if you can hear the music, please let me know. Or if things are too loud, or my mic isn't loud enough. I don't say that every time, but yeah, I never know. Ah, okay, so the opponent had to do it this way, yeah, to cast Mammoth, that's kind of funny. Okay, well, this gets put in the oven. And do we just kill Mammoth right now? Oh, second cat, I should probably play Castle Lockwain because I could draw a tower next turn. I could also play Midnight Reaper. I just don't want to get cleaved. If I can avoid it. So yeah, I think I could also do. No, I can't. Yeah, I think I'll just kill the Mammoth in case they have something like Great Hand, sure. Some shit. I mean, I could also chump block with the cat, which is not unreasonable, but I think I like this. They probably have company though, to be fair, and not Embercleave. I wonder how if they have any answers for Mayhem Devil main deck. Alright, just a little Sortar Goblin. Okay, so there is an answer to Mayhem Devil. Nope. Okay. Well, that's not gonna work out well for the opponent. Oh. Claim the Firstborn. Do we even want to claim anything here? Nah. Ah, maybe. Yeah, we can just clear the board here. I feel like that's pretty good. Just steal this. Attack for six. It's almost lethal as well. Should we take the damage? Yeah, just scoop. Makes sense. There was also a very odd visual bug. Like the opponent scoot mid-combat, and so we saw them take 3 damage from Devil, go to 9. And then before they took 3 damage from the Goblin, or like as they took that damage, they went to 3 life because they scooped. But then they went up to 6 life again. So I'm not quite sure what that was. Because it would make sense if they like go to 0 when they scoop. Well, that wasn't the case here. Also, do you still play the Surtar Goblin when you have Voltaic Brawler? I think a lot of people just haven't really incorporated Voltaic Brawler in their rule lists for whatever reason. I could maybe have more Butchers and no Reapers. I think Reaper is like not the worst. And Butcher's like fine early, but not in multiples. But it can still trade with the X2s, which is, you know, not irrelevant. Oh wait, Bowman Curia is probably worse. Yeah, we can just do this. Maybe I want Angrath. Yeah, sure. But these are the types of games I want to play, so I can finish in time, that's for sure. Well, I probably won't be the types of games I'll play, because according to teammates, there's a lot of Sultai. Okay. This works, I hope. I actually played against Gruul, I think like 2 times on ladder as well, in testing for this. I learned that when they have Gruul spell breakout, you should not pass the turn with Priest of the Forgotten Gods. So that was cool. My little Pell Collector. I think we still just play Up and Out now. I want to shock turn 1 so that I don't shock turn 2 and like show them that I have stuff. It's just, I mean, it doesn't really matter because they can see it from like the way arena pauses. Alright. Ooh, is it a one-lander? No, it's not. I always hope for the one-lander. Never get it. Am I supposed to just main face Noxious Grasp? I don't think so. But I think I will kill Pell Collector over something like a Mammoth here. Is this Spellbreaker? It's Rampaging Ferocidon. How about we kill a Pell Collector response so we still get to gain the life? The Frostedon is pretty good, but I guess Ghost Rider can trade for it. Oh, that was actually kind of nice. I think I play Ghost Rider here. Yeah, I think that's worth doing. We need some claim to Firstborn here, please. And no cleave as well. That would be very nice. If the opponent could just have no cleave. Questing Beast. Okay, I'm not a big fan of Questing Beast here, but... I'm not attacking with Ferocidon. Wisely. I'm just trading for Apocalypse then. And then I'm playing Midnight Reaper. I feel like that Ferocidon should absolutely attack. Because I just make this block round, then play Midnight Reaper next turn and can... block Ferocidon. I am like going dangerously low, like to 10, then to 9, then I can make this trade, go to 8. Plus 4, go to 4 life, yeah. Do I, no I can't sacrifice the Goat Token, I need that to block the Ferocidon next turn. And with these Fable Passages, oh, Angrath, hello. So, yeah, I think I want to play the Fable Passage here. not 100% sure it's correct. But I think so, letting me Woe Strider later. Maybe it is actually as better to just Black Crypt. Yeah, it probably was better to. Because if I'm just going to play Angrath the turn after. But I'm not sure I will. Because the Woe Strider can trade with the Questing Beast. So if my opponent just Bricks here, I actually like am in a good spot. Because I can play Woe Strider next turn. Because I played Fable Passage. Okay, Spellbreaker. So this puts me to 1 life. Which is not great. By not great, I mean I will die because of that. Oh. Okay, well, it's not hasty. That helps. I wonder if I'm just supposed to block with Reaper here. I can use Angrath to kill the Ferocidon. So that's kind of cool. I can also use it to kill Questing Beast, actually. If I want to. If I just take the damage here and I just play Angrath, and I steal the Questing Beast, attack with that and kill it. I go to 4 life. Nah, then I just die to like a mountain next turn. I can't just Woe Strider next turn. I guess I will do this. Oh, a braid. Interesting. No, that's not quite good enough. So opponent still has a card in hand, which has to be a spell probably. So if I put Woe Strider into play, I think I have to go to 1 life here. And like, it sucks, but I think that's what I have to do. Yeah, I'll just take the Questing Beast. Like, we die to most things here, but it's okay. If we somehow survive here, which, I mean, I hope it's like a forest or Cassandra Mammoth or something like that, then maybe these food tokens will help us survive. Yeah, and that's, no, that's not lethal. We can jump like with the goat. And I'd have to make the decision of like whether to keep Angrath alive. I mean, I assume they have, I assume it's not gonna make them discard anything. It If we have to jump onto the goat, though, we can't play Ghost Rider. It's an issue, but that's probably okay. Oh, and... Okay. Fair enough. Opponent figured it out. And we died. Am I still alive? Yeah, I should be live, right? It just says that I'm offline. Hold on, let me... Okay. Definitely like the fourth butcher on the play. Not sure I like the Angrath at all, actually. It's just like dies too easily, so. I still don't think I want the Bomats. I think this is fine. Magma Spray is a mean one, but we can beat that. Mm-mm. It doesn't work. This works very well though. We should repo Ghost Rider here. I think it's okay to keep the Reaper. Because I am, you know, on 6 on the play, so I think I need the extra fear cards. Oh no, is this? Okay. Punished. Hopefully they don't have a Bone Crusher as well, but at least there's a Braid helps a bit. Don't be Bone Crusher. Okay, I think we can live with this. Hasty, sure, that makes sense. Right, I'll just play Midnight Reaper. I think I will trade it off. But maybe I shouldn't. It might be better not to trade it off. Because it makes draws like claims so much better. Or like any creature. Hello, Ferocidon. Yeah, I think we just say no blocks here. Nice! So, I guess I just grabbed the Ferocidon. Activate this. Oh, hello, Mayhem Devil. Nice. So, we can play Mayhem Devil and keep up a Braid. So what if there's a questing beast here? We can probably deal with that somehow. Why am I always starting so late? Yeah, I know. I just didn't know what to play when I woke up. So I have to spend some time figuring that out. I know that's a common occurrence for me. Also, like, I'm just in my prime later in the day. Do I just upgrade that now? I think so. Like, yeah, because I don't really want to draw, like, sacrifice my Mayhem Devil if I draw a creature anyway. So I think we just kill that right away. Okay, that's cute. So, we attack for 3 here, and I think we just put Gigantha in hand, play Witch's Oven. And a tap Black Crypt here. Like, we don't quite have lethal next turn. That's close. So this went well. I wonder what they could have here. Because, like, last time they played, you know, just tap Tommy Crown and Rampaging Frost on. I guess they just have, like, more 3 drops than 2 drops. Because that's basically all their deck is. They probably don't have company. They can Bone Crusher my Priest now. I'm okay with that. I think it may be okay if they kill a Mayhem Devil. Like, Gigantha's just so good that I don't really mind that. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Noxious Grasp. So I can like play Gigantha and clear their board. But it does not sound like something I'm interested in. I think I'd rather just kill your Spellbreaker. Oh no. Okay. We'll 3 damage here. We don't die to a cleave. So we're fine. And then next turn, like if they play something like Questing Beast, they just die now. So Gigantha plus Activate Priest. So. This seems good. Oh no, company, whatever will I do? I mean, I hope they can't hit anything that does something. Alright, that's definitely not something that does something. Unless they have a forest here. They, actually, the one life they gain is relevant. That will mean that I don't have lethal. But then I'll just like, you know, play Gigantha and pass the turn and like win later. Oh, okay, there's not an untapped green source. Huh, what if they had that in hand? Oh, it's turn 2 plus Symbiosis. Right, but it's, yeah, that's funny. Yeah, they definitely got punished for playing that over a forest here. Which, they're probably not supposed to do, because the Symbiosis is just not that good of a card. And they have like, Rubank Crag in their deck probably. Oh, they probably don't have Rubank Crag in their deck, right? Realistically? Because they have all these deserts and such, they probably don't have that many mountains and forests. Alright. There we go. Alright. Game one in the banks, that took 20 minutes. Yeah. We'll be fine, we'll be fine.